God is doing it again. Every chance we let him. The Bible says that Jesus couldn't do many mighty works in his own hometown. Why? Why? They knew him lack of faith. That's right. He said because of their lack of faith. Yes. Yes. Glory. You got your Bible, say amen. Amen, amen, amen. God is so awesome all the time. Get your Bible out. Put your finger there. But just go ahead and get your Bible out. Turn to Psalm 109. Psalm 109. That's pretty simple to find. It's right before Psalm 110 and after Psalm 108.
110.
I mean, 110. Yeah. I tell you what, it's definitely before Psalm 110. It's definitely before Psalm 110. Y'all stand for the reading of the word. This morning is a landmark message that's so powerful, you may not feel the power today. Have you ever, look, I remember when I was getting ready to have a colonoscopy, they told me, you used to be drinking that big old gallon of stuff. Well, he said, when I had to get my second colonoscopy, he says, take these six little pills and drink this little bitty bottle. I said, okay. I was in the lab. I took the six pills and a little bitty bottle, and I sat there and thought about it and thought about it. A couple hours later, I'm still thinking about it. I said, that man played a joke on me. About an hour later, the joke was definitely on me. See, he did. I didn't realize when I took it what it was going to do. Okay? He did, I didn't. Well, this is going to be the same way. You may take it today and go, well, this may not be so hot, but I'm going to tell you what, in the days to come, this is going to hit you like those six little pills hit me. I'm telling you, this is something. Matter of fact, it's so powerful, and I'm not just throwing this out there, so powerful. The more I read it, the more powerful it got, the more powerful it got. Last night, I was going to shoot the whole lot at you at one time, and I said, no, can't do that. We're going to do one thing today, and next week we're going to go to the other part. So maybe all of it. If not, we'll go another week. But it has to be slow, deliberate, and easy because this, if you're not camping there, you know somebody who's camping here. And it's so important because if you want deliverance, this is the delivering sermon. Okay, ready? Get your Bibles out. Psalm 109. We're just going to read the first five verses to start with. Hold not thou peace, O God of my praise. For the mouth of the wicked and the mouth of the deceitful are opened against me. They have spoken against me with a lying tongue. They compassed me about also with words of hatred and fought against me without cause. For my love, they are my adversaries, but I give myself unto prayer. And they have rewarded me evil for good and hatred for my love. Stretch forth your hands this way. Father, I love you, Lord. I praise your name. I thank you for your grace. I thank you for your mercy. I know, God, that you have a way of doing things that we can't even comprehend. And then when we're trying to fix things in our own life, we'll do it according to your word and according to your priorities, things will fall into place. Help us today to put things in priority. Help us, God, to put them in your priority, not ours. And we thank you for it because today is a very powerful day if we will stop, look, and listen. In the name of Jesus, we love you. And we praise your name. And the church said,
amen,
amen, amen, amen. You be seated. You know, there was a story about three construction workers. They were sitting on a skyscraper. They were on this building up in the skyscraper, and they had to take a lunch break. So the first guy opened up his lunch box and said, oh, man, tuna again. My wife always fixes me tuna fish sandwiches. I'm sick of it. It's been like this for years. If my wife fixes me another tuna fish sandwich one more time, I'm going to jump off this building. The second guy in his lunch box said, oh, man, peanut butter and jelly. I hate peanut butter and jelly. If my wife fixes me the same thing tomorrow, I'm going to jump, too. The third man in his lunch box said, oh, man, bologna again? I'm with you guys. If I get bologna tomorrow, a bologna sandwich in my lunch box again, I'm going to jump. The next day, at lunchtime, the first guy got his tuna sandwich. And when he got his tuna sandwich, the second guy got a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and the third guy got a bologna sandwich. So they all jumped off the skyscraper. Whoop, whoop, whoop. The cops came and caught the three construction workers' wives in the bloody scene. The wife of the first guy said, I would not have fixed him something like that. I would have fixed him a different sandwich if he just told me what he wanted. The second wife says, if he just told me what he wanted, he was tired of peanut butter and jelly, I would have fixed him something different. The third wife says, I don't understand. He makes his own lunch.